Students, this will be your lecture 9 of concrete technology. So today we are going to start with new chapter that's called aggregate. Okay, so if anybody didn't know what is aggregate, we can say the stone part. Okay, concrete mein jo patthar hota hai, the stone part is known as aggregates. Now let us see what is aggregate. Okay, let us see civil engineering definition of aggregate. It is the materials used for manufacturing of mortar and concrete. Okay, so aggregates are mainly used for manufacturing of mortar and concrete. Concrete, you know, right? Concrete, what is concrete? Concrete mein hum kya kya mix karte hai? Concrete mein we have cement, we have sand, we have stones, we have water, so these are all concrete. तो उसमें जो stones और जो sand particles होंगे, जितने भी sand या stones जो भी हम लगाएंगे, pebbles, जो भी हम what do we call that, gravels वगैरह, stones, पत्थर जो भी लगाएंगे, वो आपका concrete part है, ठीक है? और in mortar. Now what is mortar? Mortar is a mixture of cement, sand and water. Okay, it will only consist of cement, sand and water. आपने देखा होगा जब कोई wall बना रहा है, brick wall बना रहा है, तो हर एक brick को रखने के बाद, ठीक है, हर bricks को हम एक brick के ऊपर जब दूसरा brick रखते हैं, तो इन दोनों के बीच में एक cement का layer लगाते हैं. देखा होगा आपने, cement का paste लगाते हैं. वो actually cement paste नहीं है, वो cement mortar है, ठीक है? उसमें cement, water और sand mix है, ठीक है? तो mortar में aggregate कौन है? Sand, ठीक है? Concrete में aggregates कौन-कौन है? Sand और जो gravels हम लगाएंगे, ठीक है? Let us see examples क्या-क्या है gravel का? Sand, okay? Gravels, stones and pebbles. We will see each term, ठीक है? Pebbles किसको बोलते हैं? Gravels किसको बोलेंगे? Sand किसको बोलेंगे? हम सब उसको अभी देखेंगे. Now, third point, it gives the body of concrete. So, it gives body to concrete. Like for example, हमारी body अगर हम देखेंगे, तो हमारी body को shape कौन देता है? एक proper एक structure कौन देता है? Bones देते हैं ना? जो हमारे अंदर bones है, वो एक proper structure देते हैं हमारी body को. Similarly, concrete को एक structure कौन देते हैं? अपना aggregates. यानी कि aggregates are like bones to our body. हमारा body का जो bones होता है, वैसे similarly concrete का bones है aggregates. Okay? It occupies almost 70 to 80% of concrete volume. ठीक है? तो पूरे volume of concrete में से aggregate का portion 70 to 80% is your aggregates one. Now, let us classify aggregates according to source, size and shape. We are going to classify it. We are going to differentiate it, okay? According to source, size and shape. So, number one, let us see source. Sorry. Almost all natural aggregates origin from bedrocks. That is either igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks or metamorphic. I don't know if you have studied about these rocks, but I'm sure you must have studied in geography or even in first year. I think you must have. But let us just take it as a revision. So what it is saying, almost all natural aggregates originate from bedrock. Yani ki jitna bhi aggregates hai, all aggregates, they all come from a big rock. Ek bada sa main parent rock hoga. Theek hai, parent rock. Bahut bada rock hoga. Aur jab uska disintegrate hota hai, when that rock undergoes weathering, when that rocks undergo disintegration because of the heat of the sun or because of the rain or because of the wind, then those parent rock, it breaks, it disintegrates, then it becomes different kind of different kind of aggregates. Either it becomes like sand or it becomes like small boulders or pebbles or gravels. Now, mainly there are three types of bedrocks. One is igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. Let us see what is igneous rocks. They make highly satisfactory aggregates. So say igneous rocks are very good aggregates for concrete tubs. Okay. They are hard, tough, and dense. Okay. So they are very hard. Tough means it do not break easily. It's like it can handle impact very well. It can resist impacts very well. And dense. Dense matlab, you know, right? It has very high, yani ki properly packed hai. It is not loose. The rocks are not loose, but it's very heavily dense. They occur widely on earth. Okay, matlab everywhere it's found abundantly. You can find igneous rocks everywhere, like easily. And if you remember, how is igneous rocks formed? Igneous rocks are mainly formed due to the cooling of magma, right? Cooling of magma. So what is magma? What is magma? When I'm sure you must be knowing what is magma, right? If you don't know what is magma, then please take it as an assignment to go and learn what is magma, what is lava. Now secondly, let's see sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks, how are they formed? Please learn how are they formed, okay? If you have already learned, well and good. But if you have not learned, then please learn. Sedimentary rocks, they vary. Sedimentary rocks, they vary depending upon cement material and pressure under which rocks have originally compacted. Okay, so sedimentary rocks, it depends on how well the rocks have been originally compacted, how it has been made. Agar wo properly compact hoke bana hai, then it might be strong. But if it is loosely compacted, if it does not have enough strength, then the sedimentary rock may not have good property. They vary from soft to hard, okay? They are either soft or hard. Porous to dense. Porous, what is porous? Porous means any rock that has pores through which water can pass through. Porous means any rock, ठीक है, जिसमें छेद होगा, small small छेद होगा, और जिससे अगर आप पानी पास करोगे तो पानी उससे पास होगा. तो porous भी हो सकता है या फिर dense भी हो सकता है. Dense मतलब एकदम densely packed, मतलब materials are like very heavily packed, बहुत अच्छे से the materials of the aggregates are heavily packed. Or they can be light weighted, or they can be heavy. Example, siliceous sandstones, limestones, they are all example of budding. Then third comes metamorphic rocks. They have foliated structure. Okay, what is foliated structure? Foliated structure means any structure that is like, if I draw, like foliated structure means layer structure, ek ke upar ek, like when they are layer structure. Okay, when, so this kind of structure is known as foliated structure, when they are in layers. Okay, so repetitive layering. Example, quartzite and gneiss. So they are example of rocks, different kind of rocks. Now this is very important, classification of according to size. Okay, so according to size, size maximum size that can be used is 80 mm. So the maximum size of aggregate that we can use is 80 mm, yani 8 cm. You can imagine ki 8 cm diameter wala rock kitna bada hoga, theek hai? Maximum hum utna use kar sakte hain, but maximum size is limited by thickness of section and spacing of reinforcement, mixing, handling and placing technique. Means it's saying that